Okay, so before I cut, after having ironed my fabric, I'll have to explain to you what is meant by the grain line. Okay, so every fabric has grain lines, okay, that you have to follow when placing your fabric. Okay, so we have the straight grain, that's the one that goes along the selvage. Okay, that's what Yoruba people call etiaje. Okay, so for this calico now, this is the straight grain, the one that goes just along the length of the selvage. Okay, that's the straight grain. Across is this way, and if you see that when you pull it, it gives a little, that means it has a little stretch in it. And this is the bias grain, that's the one when you do 45 degrees. If you want to cut a bias, that one is one that gives you the most stretch. But on this straight grain, the fabric doesn't stretch much. It doesn't stretch at all if it's not a stretch fabric. Then it will give you a little stretch if it's a stretch fabric. Except if it is a fabric that stretches both ways. So if you are cutting a cotton fabric, jeans, any kind of fabric, you should test the grain first. And then you place your pattern accordingly. So that cross grain is the place that is supposed to be around your body. It's the one that will stretch a bit to give your body that, to give the dress that shape. Your straight grain is the one that comes down, it's vertical. Okay, and then the straight grain is also important, especially when you are fixing your zip. All these little details are the ones that are going to give you a perfect finish when you are making a dress. When you're fixing a zip in a dress, it will make that dress bulge. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and place my pattern. Okay, so I'll place this one first. Okay, since I've added my allowance, I'll just go ahead and pin it. Okay. And you can see that I folded my fabric on folder. It's in two pieces. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and pin. And then I can place other ones too. Remember I said this one will be on fold. So this place is on fold. So this place is just going to be right at the edge of it. Okay, so go ahead and pin. When we're done cutting, we'll remember to notch. Here, your hip line is a reference point. So when you are cutting, you are going to notch that place. So that when you are joining the front and the back, you pin it at the hip line. And you make sure that the hip line, they touch. Okay. So to explain the notch. When you are cutting and you are going, after cutting, you notch right on the hip line. Remember that I'm using cutter to sew this one, so I'll just give it a small notch, something that is not up to a cutter. So the notch will look like this. Okay, so this is the line where you are going to pin the front to the back when you are joining the front to the back.